Hi guys, this is going to be a makeup tutorial for this glam to gore vampire makeup look. And I filmed most of the glam part for the Daily Mail, so that will be up on the 31st of October. And I'll post all over my social media when that tutorial is up. So make sure to follow me on those so you're updated. And I will leave the link in the description bar once it's up as well. For the eyes, I'm going in with Stealth just across my crease into the brow bone and contouring down my nose. And then the Morphe Brushes 35M palette using a grape shade on top of Stealth. And then a dark purple shade all over the lid. And this doesn't need to be neat, as this is an undead glam look. It can be messy. And then I'm going in with a black to further smoke out. To add a bit more to the transition shade, I'm using Makeup Geek's Bitten, and I'm also using that on the lower lash line to give an irritated, tired look. To give a bloody look for the lower lash line, I'm using a red lip gloss. And to give a more of a bloody look, I'm using Ben Nye's Dark Blood Aged and Oxidized. For lashes, I'm using Girls With Attitude Raven Lash, and you can get 10% off if you use the discount code GRD-BP. I wanted to hollow out my cheekbones a bit more because I felt like I didn't look dead enough. I'm using Makeup Geek Mocha, Stealth and Corrupt. And for lips, I'm using Jeffree Star Cosmetics Unicorn Blood. So that's the glam part of this tutorial. Make sure to check out the Daily Mail's video if you want to watch the full detailed look. Once that's posted, I will leave that linked everywhere so you can check it out. But for the gore version, I'm really defining those veins even more with Bitten and Corrupt. If you do go in a bit too heavy-handed like I did, just go in with your foundation brush or your finger and just blend it into your skin to fade out the product. And then do that all over your face, as this is a gore version. I want veins everywhere. To make my brows look really intense, I'm just frowning and following the natural crease that my brow would make, just so I can look a bit more evil and scary looking. I wanted a Queen of the Damned style brow, so that's why I'm flicking it out at the end. I wanted my veins to look even more intense, so I'm just going over some of them with Bitten again, blending them back in with my finger or foundation brush. For the blood, I'm using Meron's Squirt Blood in Dark. I'm just taking a tissue and scrunching it up to give that really nice crinkled effect to make the blood look really patchy. Just splotch it around your entire mouth where you think the blood would have gone if you were just chomping on someone's neck or heart or whatever. And to create sort of like blood clots, I'm using Ben Nye's Fresh Scab Blood. And I'm just going to be placing that in random areas of the mouth. But if you don't have this, you can use cotton and just dip that into fake blood. And then back in with the Meron Squirt Blood. Just drip that over the corners of your mouth so it looks like you have just been eating someone and the blood is just dripping from where your mouth is open. And then I'm drawing little fang marks with Makeup Geek Latte and Ben Nye's Scab Blood. And to cause some irritation, I'm using Makeup Geek's Bitten. Then I'm using Corrupt and Bitten to put all over my teeth. So that's the finished tutorial, guys. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give the video a thumbs up, subscribe, and make sure to follow me on Instagram for more Halloween inspiration. Bye!